problem 3.8 and it discusses external flow over sphere. Estimate the heat transfer from 100 watt bulb at 127 degrees Celsius air stream moving at 0.3 meter per second bulb. The bulb may be approximated as 60 mm diameter sphere. Also calculate the percentage of power loss by convection. So in order to solve this problem, let us first draw the schematic. So as you can see in the figure 1, it represents air flow over an incandescent bulb. Incandescent bulb means the bulb is switched on and it is illuminating light. So one such bulb is there at a surface temperature TS and air with mean free steam velocity U infinity, temperature T infinity and convective heat transfer coefficient H is flowing over this bulb surface. Since bulb surface temperature is more than the air temperature, so there will be heat lost from this bulb surface to the air by convection. The figure 2 represents the schematic of this bulb, and this figure is drawn considering the bulb as a solid sphere of diameter D and air is flowing over this bulb with relative velocity U infinity and temperature T infinity. So there will be heat loss from this bulb as a sphere to the air. After drawing the detailed schematic, let us again list all the given parameters. So then the very first parameter is given to us is rating of this bulb, maximum wattage capacity of the bulb, power rating capacity of this bulb as 100 watt, its surface temperature TS is 127 degrees Celsius, the fluid temperature T infinity as 27 degrees Celsius, mean free steam velocity of the air is 0.3 meter per second, and diameter of the bulb as sphere as 60 mm, that is 0.06 meter. Step number 3 is to make assumptions. So let us make some assumptions for facilitation of the solution of this problem. So assumption number 1, one-dimensional steady-state heat transfer. Assumption number 2, no heat transfer due to radiation, purely convective heat transfer is taking place. Assumption number 3, constant properties of the air as a fluid flowing over this sphere, spherical bulb. Assumption number 4, air is considered as an ideal gas. And assumption number 5, the bulb is approximated or considered as a sphere. Then step number 4 is to identify the reference temperature. As air being the fluid is flowing over this spherical shaped bulb, as it is an external flow, and as per the thumb rule, unless otherwise stated, mean field temperature can be taken as reference temperature in this case. So mean field temperature is nothing but Tf is equal to Ts plus T infinity by 2. Ts is 127, T infinity is 27. So average of this will be mean field temperature as 77 degree Celsius. Okay. Now, step number 5 is to obtain thermophysical properties. So, for air at mean film temperature of 77 degrees Celsius, from heat transfer data book, page number, once again I refer, 34, I am taking heat transfer data book by CPV Kothandaram. Okay. So let us refer to data book. So this is the data book I have, page number 34. Once again, before referring this data book, I will make sure that the pressure is atmospheric. So from the problem statement, it is very clear the bulb is incandescent, and generally the bulb is illuminated in the room, and room generally is at atmospheric condition. So from that I can say all these external flow conditions are prevailing at one atmospheric pressure. Okay. So after making sure that conditions are associated with one atmospheric pressure, now for dry air and mean temperature of 77 degrees Celsius, I will be obtaining thermophysical properties. So while referring the table, we come to know that for 77 degrees Celsius temperature, thermophysical properties are not there. So I have to interpolate these properties for 77 degrees Celsius between 70 degrees Celsius and 80 degrees Celsius. Okay. So let us first found out the density so I will be interpolating here. Okay. So after interpolation, for TF is equal to 77 degrees Celsius. So how can I obtain density as 77 degrees Celsius? So interpolation formula will be like this. General formula I am writing. So if X is the thermophysical properties at 77 degrees Celsius, so base value will be at 70 degrees Celsius, then temperature of 77 minus temperature of 70 degrees Celsius, please let me write this very clearly. This will be equal to the thermophysical properties at 70 degrees Celsius, thermophysical property at 80 degrees Celsius over 70 degrees Celsius minus 80 degrees Celsius. So from here, from this formula, I can get any unknown thermophysical properties at 77 degrees Celsius. So this way I can obtain the values of all thermophysical properties at 77 degrees Celsius. For example, if I want to calculate density at 77 degrees Celsius, So density is 77 minus density at 70 degrees Celsius, then 77 minus 70 over density at 70 degrees Celsius, density at 80 degrees Celsius over 70 minus 80. After putting all these values, rho 77 minus density at 70 degrees Celsius is, for that I have to refer to the table, 1.029 and 1. So 1.029, this will become 70 degrees Celsius. Density is 70 degrees, 1.029 minus 1.00 over minus 10. So after the calculation, density at 77 degrees Celsius will be 1.0087 kg per meter cube. So in this session, you can calculate thermophysical properties. Now I will request you don't show this detailed calculation in your calculation. So whatever the formula is there and whatever calculations you are doing, you do it on your calculator and you write the end result. You need not to show all these calculations. You need not to show this formula, you need not to write these two expressions. You directly practice on calculator in such a way that you will be able to calculate the density or all other thermophysical properties directly. Okay. I am writing because I have to explain it to you. So, following same trade, I can get the thermophysical properties like new, so I can get new in the similar fashion as 20.769 into 10 to power minus 6 meter square per second. Prandtl number is 0.6926. Thermal conductivity of air as 0.030227 watt per meter Kelvin, and Cp is equal to 1009 joule per kg Kelvin. Now I am not asking you to show all these calculations, because it will take lot of time to write all these expressions and you won't get any marks for showing this calculation. Ultimately, we are interested in these intermediate thermophysical properties at 77 degrees. Okay. Now, after finding out thermophysical properties, step number 6 is boundary conditions. So clearly the bulb as a spherical body and its surface temperature is given. So it is constant wall temperature boundary condition. State number 7, nature of flow. So for that we have to calculate Reynolds number. And since sphere is having diameter, and whatever Reynolds number we will be calculating to decide the nature of flow over the spherical body will be based upon its diameter. So Reynolds number will be represented by R is suffix C. And it can be given by nu into Lc over, u infinity into Lc over nu. Now for a sphere, Nc, that is characteristic length, will be equal to its diameter. So Reynolds number will be u infinity is let me check the value of u infinity. 0.3. Diameter is 0.06 meter. And the value of nu is 20.769. Into add value of average convective heat transfer coefficient. So once again from HE data book, so if you will refer the data book page number 112, we are interested in the appropriate correlation of Nusselt number for sphere. So this is for flat plate. For turbulent flow. Then for flow over cylinders. So page number 120, flow over spheres. Now there are different formulae given, flow over or across spheres, one formula is this, another is this. For air, for liquid, for large property variation, 3.2 oils and waters, 3.2 large property variations, gases and liquids, 3.3 falling liquid drops, 3.4 liquid metals. So there are different formulae are given, but the formula which I would recommend as a general expression will be this. we will be selecting this general formula. And for this formula, properties are to be considered as at mean field temperature. Okay. So, from page number 120, general formula that is Nusselt number is equal to 0.037 R e power 0.6. This is the most general appropriate formula, so I am selecting this only. Okay. So the Nusselt number here will be H bar and NC over AF is equal to 0.37 RED 0.6. Characteristics length will be diameter, so NC will be equal to DF, KF, 0.37, RED, 0.6. After obtaining all these values, H bar into diameter is 0.06, the thermal conductivity of the fluid is 0.030227. Is equal to 0.37. Renault number is 866.68 power 0.6. So after calculating, I will get the value of H bar. So 10.79. Watt per meter square Kelvin. Okay. Now finally, step number 9. We are supposed to calculate heat transfer rate. So, from Newton's law of cooling, U is equal to H bar into surface area into Ts minus T infinity surface area of space taken as pi d square into Ts minus T infinity. After putting these values, 10.79 into pi into 0.06 square, 127 minus 27. So the value of Q comes out. This much amount of power energy actually will be lost from the ball due to convective heat transfer. Okay. Power loss as heat due to convective heat transfer. Now we again we have to calculate percentage loss of heat. So it can be given as heat lost due to convective heat transfer with the power rating of the bulb, and it can be given as 12.20 over 100 into 100. So this comes out 12.20 percentage. This is another answer. So this way you can solve any problem on external flow of fluid over spherical surface. This problem will guide you how to take characteristic length for the spherical surface, LC is equal to D, how to select appropriate correlation of Nusselt number for flow over spherical surface. But this way you can solve this problem.